स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग से मेरा फिर pyramids. There are three pyramids, you know. Three pyramids. Pyramids are made up of a pyramidal nucleus. They are made up of pyramidal nucleus or pyramidal backbone. Okay, this pyramidal backbone, pyramidin, is also a heterocycle ring, which is like this. This is a pyramidal nucleus. Pyramidal nucleus. We can give numbering from here. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Green color is not lightly is lightly visible now. I will make it possible because it is a new marker. Writing light very lightly. Okay, this is a pyramidal nucleus. Both purine and pyrimidine nucleus are called what? Heterocycle rings. Why are they called heterocycle rings? They are called heterocycle rings because they have different atoms in the nucleus. See here, carbon is there, carbon, nitrogen is there, carbon, 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 nitrogen. If all are carbon, all six carbons are there, means then it may be benzene. But it was replaced with two nitrogens at middle. As the two nitrogens replaced, it is a heterocycle ring. This is heterocycle ring, what we call pyrimidine nucleus. From this pyrimidine nucleus, there is a formation of remaining pyrimidine. How many pyrimidines are there? Three pyrimidines named cytosine, uracil, and thymine. Cytosine, uracil, and thymine are three pyrimidines. They are derivatives of this pyrimidine nucleus. See one by one. First one, cytosine. Cytosine. Cytosine is formed of that only. See that structure of cytosine. This is a heterocycle nucleus, right? This what is cytosine formula? Cytosine is 2-oxo. 2-oxo means 2-keto. 2-keto, what is this one? This is keto group. So keto group. So here hydrogen will come. 2-oxo, 4-amino. 2-oxo, 4-amino pyrimidine. NH is not there, double bond will come. 2-oxo-4-amino pyrimidine. Name I will write now. 2-oxo or 2-keto. 4-amino pyrimidine is cytosine. Second one, uracil. Cytosine is present in both DNA and RNA. Coming to uracil, this uracil is 2,4 dioxo or diketo pyrimidine. 2,4 diketo pyrimidine. Is uracil. See here, second carbon has keto group, fourth carbon also has keto group. So it is 2,4 dioxy or diketo pyrimidine. 2,4 diketo pyrimidine is uracil. Third one, thymine. Thymine is present only in DNA, not in RNA. See the structure of thymine. In addition to uracil, one more methyl group is added to uracil. At the fifth carbon, then it may form into thymine. See here, second carbon has keto group, fourth carbon has keto group, and fifth carbon has methyl group. So it is, how can we write the name? This is 2,4-dioxy. Dioxy means diketo. Dioxy 5-methylpyrimidine. Or we can write 5-methyluracil. 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 Why? Because here 2,4-dioxypyrimidine is uracil, right? So this uracil, if a methyl group is added at fifth carbon, then it is 2,4-dioxy-5-methylpyrimidine. That means except this methyl group, it is what, uracil. So this uracil, there is extra methyl group. So when methyl group is extra added, that is what we are calling 5-methyluracil, which is also called as thiamine. Okay, copy this. Clarity na? Clarity na?
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, this week CPT, sir, what is the portion, sir?
This week it is CPT, va?
Sir, CMN sir said, sir.
CPT means cell chapter you completed now from biomolecules up to proteins.
Okay, sir.
Right? Nucleic acids not included. Today class is not included up to last Friday class. Fully.
Okay, sir.
Okay, done. CPT portion is from beginning of the proteins, beginning of the biomolecules up to last class. End of the protein.
Okay, sir.
Okay, done. Okay, is it complete? Can I erase board?
Yes, sir.
Okay, done. These are pyrimidines. Okay, both purines and pyrimidines have heterocycle molecule. If you see the structure, you may observe purines have, if you see the purine nucleus, there is presence of two rings. First ring is the pyrimidine ring only. Write that point. Purine nucleus is made up of a pyrimidine ring and an imidazole ring. Imidazole, IMIDAZOLE, imidazole ring. okay? Then second category, second component of nucleic acid.
Second what?
Pentose nucleus. Second, yeah. Imidazole. Imidazole.
Sir, after spelling, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Imidazole. Next, pentose sugar. What are pentose sugars? These are 5-carbon sugars. 5-carbon sugars are called pentose sugars. Especially there are two pentoses in nucleic acid. What are the two pentoses? One is deoxyribose. Second one is ribose. Here the name, what we are saying, deoxyribose. It is present in DNA, whereas in RNA there is the presence of ribose. Based on the pentose sugar only, they are named as the deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid. As deoxyribose is present, it is called as deoxyribonucleic acid. As ribose is present, it is called as ribonucleic acid. Names of nucleic acids are given based on the pentose sugar presence. Deoxyribonucleic acid has deoxyribose, and ribonucleic acid has ribose. That means deoxyribose is found only in DNA, not in RNA. Whereas ribose is found only in RNA, not in DNA. See now, structures. First one is ribose. Ribose, we mentioned during the classification of monosaccharides, aldopentose, ketopentose, like that. Aldopentose example is ribose. Ribose is an example to aldopentose. Now, if you see the structure of ribose, not open chain, cyclic forms are there, no? The cyclic forms I am saying now. I am drawing here, cyclic form. This is ribose. This is deoxyribose. There are two pentoses. Ribose is present in RNA and deoxyribose is present in DNA. So based on this, pentose sugars present in that nucleic acids only, they are named as ribonucleic acid and deoxyribonucleic acid, like that. Okay, is the board clear? Anyone? Sumedha? Yeah, good.
Sir, for ribose, OH group is present downside, no sir, for second carbon.
Yes, yes, that only. I'm saying I will explain that. If you note the structure, then I will explain. I just wrote that structures. I will differentiate between the two. This is first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here this is ribose. This is deoxyribose. What is the difference here? Ribose has OH group. especially this is not second carbon, that is called as a 2 prime carbon. Prime, see here, 3 prime OH, we can say this one, 3 prime OH. Why 3 prime? 3 third carbon means here carbon will be there, na? That is third carbon. But to the third carbon, there is attachment of OH group, so this is called as a 3 prime OH group. Here, at the second carbon also, there is presence of 2 prime OH group. But here, 3 prime OH is there, but 2 prime only H is there. What is the name? Deoxy. D means less, or removal, or loss. One, OH group is present in 2 prime group, 2 prime of ribose. But here, deoxy, one oxygen is less. That's why it is called as a deoxyribose. The names are given as ribose and deoxyribose because there is presence of 2 prime OH group is in RNA, but in DNA there is only hydrogen at 2 prime group. 2 prime position has only hydrogen, oxygen is lost. There is no oxygen, that's why it is named like that. Complete?
Sir, but in book at first carbon OH group is present downside, sir.
First carbon OH down or left means that may be alpha beta positions only, no problem. Why I wrote on top side is next structures will write. Suppose this is pentosugar. Pentosugar combines with one nitrogen base and forms one structure. So during that I need to show you a bond, that's why I wrote on top. First carbon has H one side, OH one side. If it is present down means that is alpha, you already know that. Sugars, and in sugars, so if OH is on right side, we need to write below carbon. If it is present left means above the carbon, we need to write. Here right means alpha, left means beta, like that it may be. Here alpha ribose or beta ribose or alpha deoxyribose, beta deoxyribose, that is not a matter. Just in next step, I will show you the formation of bonds where nitrogen base combines with this deoxyribose. For that convenience only, I wrote OH group on top. Okay, right. Then third component. Third component of this nucleic acid is what? Third one, phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid. The formula of phosphoric acid is H3PO4. This H3PO4 phosphoric acid has this structure. Simple enough. H3PO4 is the formula. Phosphoric acid has reactive hydroxyl groups. Two hydroxyl groups are present which are reactive. Usually, three OH groups are there. Among that, this one and this one, two reactive hydroxyl groups are present. They are involved in formation of sugar phosphate backbone. Two reactive groups of H3PO4 involved in formation of nucleic acid backbone. Nucleic acid backbone is called as a sugar phosphate backbone. When we go to structure of DNA, there I will explain you that. Here two OH group is there now. One OH group is reacting with one sugar, and OH group is reacting with another sugar. That we will see in next structure. Okay. So that pentose sugar is involving. Sorry. Phosphoric acid is involving in formation of sugar phosphate backbone. Means here one sugar is there, so this a phosphate is attached. That on another side of phosphate there is a binding of another sugar. This is a sugar phosphate backbone. So phosphate group is involving in binding of sugar at one side with one OH group. Another side another sugar is bound with another OH group. Sugar phosphate backbone is formed due to this phosphate group. Okay, right. Now we'll see different compositions of nucleic acid. Here this compositions are mean three different components are present in nucleic acid. What are the three different components? Three different components present in nucleic acids are what? Nitrogen base, pentose sugar and phosphoric acid. There are three components: nitrogen base, pentose sugar and phosphoric acid. These can combine in different composition and there is formation of monomeric units of nucleic acid. Nucleic acids monomeric units are formed in different levels. Okay, we have 20 minutes more. Just I will continue a small topic, then we'll discuss about yesterday WPT mark. Yeah, note down you. It involves two OH groups of H3PO4. Two OH groups of H3PO4 forms sugar phosphate backbone. Sugar phosphate backbone. Okay. See now. Next topic, nucleoside. What is this nucleoside? Means a nitrogen base combines with a pentose sugar and forms a nucleoside. A nucleoside is formed on binding of a nitrogen base with pentose sugar. Three components are there, na? Two components are binding, so that there is formation of a structure called nucleoside. If three are bound, there is formation of another structure called nucleoside. That we will see next class. Coming to this, a nitrogen base combines with a pentose sugar, and there is formation of a nucleoside. Take an example. One purine nucleoside, one pyrimidine nucleoside I will give you. Then I will give you list. Okay. Suppose one pentose sugar I will write first here. Pentose sugar. What is pentose sugar? Suppose here I am writing ribose as a pentose. This is ribose as a pentose. To this ribose, if there is binding of a nitrogen base, suppose we can write a nitrogen base adenine. We need a big structure. Means I will write somewhat big range. This is what adenine. This is adenine. This is ribose. Between adenine and ribose, there is formation of a bond. What is the numbering here? This is the first one. Here, coming to here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The bond formed here is N glycosidic linkage. The bond formed between nitrogen base and pentose sugar is 1 N glycosidic linkage. 1 second, please. By forming N-glycosidic linkage between that nitrogen base and pentose sugar, they joined together. They joined together by forming one N-glycosidic linkage. What is the linkage formed here? N glycosidic linkage. So by forming one N glycosidic linkage, a nitrogen base combines with a pentose sugar. So this is totally a nucleoside. This is an example to purine nucleoside. Take another example. Pyrimidine nucleoside one will see. Otherwise, this is ribose, na? We'll take a deoxyribose. Pyrimidine, pyrimidine means we need to change this position. Two comma four diketo 5-methyl pyrimidine. See now. What is this? This is a thymine. This is deoxyribose. See the number? Numbering here. Numbering is from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is the bond formed between these two? Here also there is a formation of a bond called N-glycosidic bond. One, N glycosidic bond is formed between a nitrogen base and pentose sugar, so that there is formation of a nucleoside. A nucleoside is formed like this. Nucleosides are formed. That means one pentose sugar combines with a phosphoric acid. Sorry, pentose sugar combined with a nitrogen base and there is formation of a nucleoside. Here the bonding, how the bond is formed in purine. In purine, glycosidic bond is N glycosidic linkage is there, na? That N glycosidic linkage is 1C1. To N9 glycosidic linkage. First carbon, first carbon of ribose or pentose is combining with 9th position of purine. But here C1 N1 glycosidic bond. Here N glycosidic bond is formed, na? That N glycosidic bond is C1 N1 glycosidic bond where in pyrimidine. In pyrimidine, first nitrogen of pyrimidine combined with the first carbon of pentose. But in purine, ninth nitrogen at ninth position combined with first carbon of pentose sugar. That is the purine and pyrimidine nucleosides difference. Okay, up to this enough for today. Once you copy that, then tell me. We'll discuss the marks of yesterday's WPT. Okay, copy this first. Sumedha, you can stop recording.